That was your last time.
Thank you.
So that would be the question. Yeah. We never went to the Dragon before. The Dragon's not even there.
Oh, my darling. to herself.
This is living. This is absolutely living.
She was about to remark as much to her husband Henry when...
Henry was in no mood. The brand new Stutz Bearcat had not been his idea.
They certainly didn't need a car to come to America.
He tried reasoning with his wife.
And we don't need one to stay here.
But Marietta had already made up her mind. They absolutely required the brand new Stutz Bearcat.
She knew it wouldn't be long before her husband came around to her way of thinking.
What Henry Phil was thinking? Absolutely nothing of note had ever happened to him in a car.
He was about to remark as much to his wife, Marietta, when...
To their left, the overcrowded Eastland strained against its moorings as the white picnic dress passengers raced to the waterside edge of the ship.
An amateur canoe race was amateurly canoeing by.
Stroke!
To one another about their brand new Stutz Bearcat when the Eastland rolled over and died.
Oh no, we're drowning!
Martin cried.
Henry, look out!
And he did, swerving the brand new Ohio Street beachbound South Water Rider with Stutz Bearcat right off the road and into the old Chicago Port train. Upsetting the building facade,
but not dislodging
the overhead bus of Dr. Eileen K. Bonner, mother of Illinois and psychiatry.
In shock from the collision, mother failed. Try again.
Henry! Smoke-filled summer air struggled with sound of crooning and drowning and dresses and dying.
Henry failed, grabbed at the clutch. It came up in his hand!
He stopped on the brake!
Bearcat backwards!
Into the street!
Blew out his horn!
Over the Hudbro barricades! Looked to his wife.
Over the river's edge!
Before either failed realized what had hit them, the Chicago River did.
Splash! Nearly 850 people on board that ill-fated Eastland, along with Henry and Marietta Fail, sank deep into the Chicago River that morning. The same river in which, at that very moment, the middlest child,
Teddy June Fail,
was diving.
So to say that death had not played a very prominent role in the Fail family saga, the year of each of the Fail sisters' deaths would be absolute applesauce.
Yeah.